Hydrogen is often hailed as the fuel of the future, a clean and abundant source of energy that could revolutionize how we power cars, ships, planes, and even heavy industries like steelmaking. Imagine a world where the only byproduct of fuel is water, where you could drive hundreds of kilometers on a tank of hydrogen and refuel in mere minutes. This isn't some distant dream. It's already becoming a reality with companies like BMW and Toyota leading the charge. For nearly half a century, BMW has been experimenting with hydrogen, from their first hydrogen-powered vehicles in 1979 to their latest pilot fleet of hydrogen cars like the BMW X5. These fuel cell electric vehicles offer something that battery electric vehicles can't: incredible range and quick refueling times. With just a few kilograms of hydrogen, you can drive up to 600 kilometers, making hydrogen an ideal option for long-distance driving. BMW and Toyota's partnership has been crucial in bringing this technology to life. Combining Toyota's fuel cell expertise with BMW's powertrain innovation, this collaboration aims to make hydrogen a serious contender in the race for zero-emission mobility. But hydrogen isn't just about cars. It's being explored in industries like shipping, aviation, and even steel production. Swedish company SSAB has already produced the world's first fossil-free steel using hydrogen, showing that this technology has the potential to clean up some of the most polluting sectors. But while hydrogen's promise is enormous, the reality is more complex. The majority of hydrogen today is produced through processes that rely on fossil fuels, creating what's known as gray hydrogen. This method, though cheaper, is far from green, as it produces a large carbon footprint. Blue hydrogen, which captures some of the CO2 emissions, has been touted as a cleaner alternative. However, studies show that its greenhouse gas footprint may actually be worse than burning natural gas directly. The oil and gas industry, despite its claims, hasn't fully solved the issue of emissions and methane leaks in hydrogen production. On the other hand, green hydrogen, made using renewable energy like wind or solar, could offer a truly clean solution. Although it's still in its infancy and expensive compared to other forms, prices are falling as technology improves. In fact, it's predicted that by 2030, green hydrogen will be cheaper than both blue and gray hydrogen. Yet, challenges remain. Hydrogen has a lower energy density compared to natural gas, meaning it requires more space for storage and more infrastructure for transport, which might not be feasible for every use case. When it comes to passenger cars, hydrogen fuel cells face stiff competition from battery electric vehicles. Converting electricity to hydrogen and back to electricity in fuel cells results in significant energy losses, about 60%. In contrast, battery electric vehicles lose only 20% of their energy when directly charging a lithium-ion battery. Hydrogen-powered vehicles, once hailed as the future of transportation, are now facing significant setbacks, primarily due to the inadequacies in fueling infrastructure. This issue was thoroughly explored in a video by Donut Media, where they tested the Toyota Mirai, a hydrogen-fueled car with cutting-edge technology and an impressive environmental footprint, emitting only water as a byproduct.
If you live outside of some large cities in California, you might have some trouble driving anywhere.
There are currently 48 fueling stations in the state of California, mostly clustered in the San Fran and LA areas. Many of them are broken or could be out of hydrogen on any given day.
The reality of owning and operating a hydrogen car has proven to be more frustrating than expected for many. One of the biggest issues for hydrogen car owners is the lack of fueling stations. While Toyota claims that the Mirai offers up to 400 miles of range on a full tank of hydrogen, customers report far less, closer to 280 miles. Coupled with the fact that California, the primary market for the Mirai, has only 48 hydrogen fueling stations, many of which are out of service or low on fuel, refueling has become an unpredictable and time-consuming task. The Donut Media team attempted to locate a nearby hydrogen station through an app, only to discover most stations were either closed or running low on fuel. This lack of reliable fueling stations severely limits the practicality of hydrogen vehicles and is a primary reason why their sales have dropped 70% in the past year. In addition to poor infrastructure, the high cost of hydrogen fuel adds another layer of complexity. Full tank for the Mirai could total over $200. This makes hydrogen cars more expensive to operate than both gasoline-powered and electric vehicles. It seems that the dream of hydrogen cars becoming mainstream may remain just that, a dream. While hydrogen might not be the best solution for everyday passenger cars, it could make more sense for trucks, ships, and planes, where battery limitations like weight and charging times present bigger challenges. So, is hydrogen really the miracle fuel of the future? Or is it just part of the puzzle? As governments and companies invest heavily in hydrogen over the next few years, we'll start to see whether the momentum can turn into real, sustainable solutions. One thing is clear. Hydrogen is here to stay, but it won't be the only answer. What do you think? Should we bet on hydrogen or focus on other technologies? Let us know in the comments below.
What are you doing?
I'm powered by 2 hydrogen fuel cells.
You've got to be shitting me.
No, I am not shitting you.
And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Unlim Energy for more insights into the future of energy.